Hi guys and welcome. Today we're going to finally check out the Deviant Phantom Reactor 900. I think since this speaker has been released, I've gotten at least one comment under every video asking me when I'm going to review it, if I will buy it, if I'm going to test it, how it sounds, if I could already see one, get my hands on one, and now I finally managed to get one. Unfortunately, it took quite a while since DVLA didn't have any in stock until now. Yesterday, I managed to get the very last unit from my local DVLA store in a shopping mall. And I have to say, overall, I'm pretty impressed and I quite like the speaker so far. So I'm really glad to finally have one here and also compare it, test it, measure it, and of course also show it to you in this video. So let's get the technical stuff out of the way. The packaging or its overall presentation when you buy it is really great. I think it's one of the nicest packagings I've seen in a while, which I think should be addressed as they put quite a lot of effort into this. And then if you open it up in this kind of fancy box, you get the speaker, and my first thought was, wow, it is really, really tiny. So compared against the gold Phantom, it's really nothing. I think it's 4 times less the size of the normal Phantom. And overall, it's just much smaller than I anticipated. I saw it in the store, but it looked bigger for some reason. But in here, on the speaker stand, it looks really, really small. Still, on the other hand, it's also really high quality. So it's, I think, 4.5 kilograms, which is heavier than any other speaker of this size I've seen so far. And of course also the quality is great. It is assembled by hand in France or by some fancy robots, which DVLA also is very proud to show in their videos, which also looks quite cool. But yeah, overall the feel and the quality of the speaker is on point, definitely one of the best I've seen. Also design-wise, you might argue, some people say it's ugly. I think it looks really awesome, and again, the size is what impressed me most. It's a really, really small speaker, it's very compact and you can fit it nearly anywhere in your room. And of course, it still delivers some pretty big sound, which we will get into in some minutes. So before we start with the sound check, I want to go around the device for a second. So at the top, they now have a control panel, which features the loudness controls, a play and pause button, as well as a link button and a Bluetooth pairing button, which the older one didn't have. So the big Phantom back then just had an on and off button, which also didn't really work. I think it was just a reset button. On the back of the Phantom Reactor, we now additionally also have working on and off button, so if you hold it, it will turn off the device into standby. So if you're leaving the house, you will just do that, and then if you come back, you just press it one more time and it turns on again. While with the bigger Phantom, you couldn't really judge if it's on or off because there was no LED. With the Phantom Reactor, you have this small kind of LED on top of the control panel, and behind that you have the pretty big how do you say this, cooling grills, I don't know the English term for it, but you can see it now, which are of course to cool all of the electronics inside, which is logical. If you have a very small sealed box, you need some good cooling, and the Phantom Reactor definitely has that. So talking about the drivers, this one now has one driver less than the bigger brother. So there's one full inch driver at the front and the two DVLA typical subwoofers on the sides, which are both 13 centimeters in diameter. While the full inch driver I thought was a bit bigger than the real tweeter of the bigger Phantom, but it actually looks like just a 1-inch tweeter with a thicker surround. I was a bit worried about that because the cutoff frequency at around 350 Hz is quite low for a 1-inch driver, and this sometimes is hearable, might lead to some issues, but it still works out, so that's the driver layout for the reactor. So overall it's like a much smaller, slightly more refined, and of course also really high quality and good looking version of the bigger Phantom. At least in my opinion it's good looking. But now I want to stop talking and let you hear for yourself. I will compare it against two speakers, the FIFA Helsinki and the BNOS3. The FIFA is a battery powered speaker, it goes for around $400 and is known for having pretty great mid-range and treble definition, so both of them are not really comparable to the Phantom price wise, but I just want to give you an idea of how much power the Phantom creates while still remaining just as small as the others. Just like always, I'm using high quality binaural microphones to give you the most realistic sound impression possible. For those, you have to wear headphones, so make sure to put them up, and let's get into the sound check. So let's begin with comparing it to the FIFA Helsinki, which is a Bluetooth speaker. It's maybe equally sized, slightly smaller, of course also has a battery and only goes for around $400 or even less. It's not really a comparison. But I'm just showing this to give you a reference of how the Phantom sounds. Also, I think it's not a really bad idea to compare the Phantom Although the FIFA is much less expensive to a speaker and an equal size, you won't find any other speaker at this price point that has this kind of size factor, while the FIFA is quite comparable. So I just want to give you an example of how the Phantom compares to another speaker and the size. So please don't hate at me in the comments. I'm trying to do or arrange another comparison against more expensive speakers. This will follow up in a separate video, but for now I just want to give you a quick reference against some speakers that you might already know and that represent good sound quite nicely. For example, the FIFA Helsinki right here. So again, make sure to put up your headphones and let's begin.
What do you want from me? Why don't you run from me? What are you wondering? What do you know? Why aren't you scared of me? Why do you care for me? When we all fall asleep, where do we go?
Come here.
Say it, spit it out. What is it exactly? Your pain is the amount cleaning you out. Am I satisfactory? Today I'm thinking about the things that are deadly. The way I'm drinking you down, like I wanna drown, like I wanna end me. Step on the glass, staple your tongue. Bury a friend, try to wake up. Cannibal class, killing the sun. Bury a friend, I wanna end me.
There were people on the sidewalks.
Sidewalks.
Running down the avenue.
Avenues.
Us sitting outside in cafes.
Cafes.
We were looking for the muse.
For the muse.
Well, I was locked in by the system. Where no freedom is the rule. Now I spend all my time. Make it understood.
Understood.
It once was my life.
Was my life.
That's what everybody said.
We'll be right back.
So this is it from the comparison against the FIFA. As you could hear, I played some tracks on a normal volume and then on a higher volume to just show what the Phantom is all about, and this is also what I think makes it really special. It just resembles a much bigger speaker. Of course, it comes with a compromise. Fitting such big drivers in a small housing always has disadvantages as well, but still, it just resembles a much bigger speaker. When it comes to loudness and when it comes to keeping the bass at loud volumes. The FIFA could play equally loud, but has way less, air to move up. So it was at around 90% volume, while the DVLA was at around 70% volume. And it kept all of the bass, really sounded powerful. And this is just what makes it special. It resembles a much bigger speaker when it comes to the power appearance, even at higher volumes, compared to other speakers like the FIFA or the Harman Kardon, as we will see in some minutes. Where the FIFA definitely wins, though, is in treble resolution. It somehow sounds more refined. Keep in mind, it of course also has a, I think, bigger treble boost than the DVLA. I put it to late night in order to make it a bit more comparable to the Phantom. Late night in the with the FIFA boosts bass, and I think treble a little bit in order to make it a bit more full and a bit more a bit more powerful sounding, I'd say. We will see the responses now. They both measure nicely, I'd say. The Phantom definitely has a bigger bass boost, while the FIFA, of course, also has a treble boost, so that's why it might sound a bit more refined, but I think it simply delivers a bit more resolution than the full-inch driver in the DVLA. And it, of course, also has two drivers, which makes it stereo, while the Phantom is mono, and that already makes the FIFA more high-end sounding in the treble region and probably also in the mid-range region. So talking about the mid-range, I think the Phantom definitely isn't bad in the treble or the mid-range. It sounds solid, of course, also thanks to this nice shape of the housing. It has really great dispersion, while the FIFA, with two exact same drivers mounted on one baffle, it will have some, cancelling out when you turn it around, so the dispersion really isn't that great, while with the DVLA it's pretty nice. But still, when it comes to, of course, treble separation, which the Phantom has none of, treble resolution, as well as probably the mid-range, I would pick the FIFA. But anything under, 300 Hz, under 350 Hz, where the subwoofers of the DVLA take over, the DVLA just wins. Also on higher volumes, it keeps way more control over the bass. Of course, also it's not battery powered. It might also be slightly bigger than the FIFA, but I just want to demonstrate this, as this is, I think, quite impressive, special, and this is also what makes the Phantom special overall. You know, the mid-range and treble isn't bad or anything, but it's also not the highlight of the speaker. The bass, rather, is the highlight of the speaker and the overall capabilities also when it comes to higher volumes. So now let's start with a comparison against the Harman Kardon, which might be a bit more comparable sound-wise. It is mono as well, also has a bass boost, quite a big bass boost, so they should be similar. Also, the Harman Kardon is bigger than the Phantom, so it might have one advantage. But on the other hand, again, it's even less expensive than the FIFA. You can find it for below $200, so this really isn't a fully fair comparison. I just want to show you what the Phantom does despite its small size. So again, make sure to put up your headphones, I will let you listen, and later on give you my thoughts.
Bye.
exactly? Your pain is the amount cleaning you out. Am I satisfactory? Today I'm thinking about the things that are deadly. The way I'm drinking you down, like I wanna drown, like I wanna end me. Step on the glass, staple your tongue. Bury a friend, try to wake up. Cannibal class, killing the sun. Bury a friend, I wanna end.
There were people on the sidewalks,
sidewalks,
running down the avenue,
avenues,
but sitting outside in cafes,
cafes.
We were looking for the muse,
for the muse.
Well, I was locked in by the system, where no freedom is the rule. Now I spend all my time. Make it understood.
Understood.
It once was my life.
Was my life.
That's what everybody said.
And that is it from the Harman Kardon. I think this one definitely kept up nicer with the Phantom on higher levels. Definitely, I would say overall sounds warmer than the Phantom, while the FIFA rather had a, cooler and thinner character than the Phantom. Yeah, the Harman Kardon also, that's why I included that one track by Billie Eilish. It's her new one. I think I put it in anyways, called Bury a Friend. It has a really heavy bass and I love testing speakers with it. It also shows you, or at least with my DIY speakers, always shows you if anything is distorting, if anything isn't sealed properly, if the housing isn't sealed, if the port is making noises, it will instantly show that. And both with the FIFA and the Harman Kardon, you could hear some rattling. It was more obvious with the FIFA, but with the Harman Kardon you get it as well. Also on higher volumes it gets even stronger, while with the Phantom it will remain clean all the time. Also thanks to the really stable housing, thanks to the push-push design of the two woofers. which is typical for them. The bigger Phantom has it as well, and that just makes the speaker insanely quiet when it comes to vibrations, as well as of course that nice round shape, which makes the speaker even more durable when it comes to the housing than, let's say, the FIFA or the Harman Kardon. Otherwise, I would say, again, those are more comparable than the FIFA and the DVLA. My critique, or my verdict on this comparison will of course be slightly unfair. So again, don't hate on me, just know the Harman Kardon is a great deal for under $200. It definitely kept up nicely for a speaker that is, I don't know, 5 to 6 times less expensive than the DVLA. But when it comes purely to sound, I would say that the DVLA beat the Harman Kardon. The Harman Kardon sometimes sounded, again, a bit warmer, a bit more relaxed, also sometimes a bit more dense. Maybe slightly more treble resolution, as that full range driver, or how they are calling it, on the front of the Phantom is crossing over pretty low. So it's crossing over at around 350 Hz, which is really low for such a small driver. And this might lead to some, distortion in the mid-range, section, which you can also see in the distortion graph. Others, like the FIFA or the Harman Kardon, won't have this. And this is why I would maybe call it a tie when it comes to treble and mid-range. It just prefers on what you want more. If you want a treble boost, a slightly more open and more treble boosted character, go with the Phantom. Again, also has nicer dispersion due to the nice and round shaped housing. But if you want a more relaxed, smooth and laid back sound, the Harman Kardon probably is the one for you. When it comes to bass, I would just have to give it to the Phantom. The Harman Kardon again sounds warmer, more laid back. But it just was missing the control. It has a really big bass boost as well, so it's not a really linear sounding speaker in the bass area. Also doesn't reach as low as the Phantom, and of course on higher volumes it gets quite soft. While the FIFA still remains quite kicking, the Harman Kardon tends to get soft quickly. And again, the same game here. The Harman Kardon was at around 90% volume with the last few tracks, while the DVLA was at around 70% volume and still was louder and, more forward and a bit more powerful, or way more powerful sounding than the Harman Kardon. So when it comes to bass and overall control in the bass, I think that's the right word. When it comes to control and overall bass power, bass appearance also on higher volumes, again, the Phantom beats the Harman Kardon, which is obvious, which you would expect for the price point, but it's not so obvious if you look at the size difference. They are maybe they have the same volume, a similar volume, but the Harman Kardon is just quite a bit bigger than the DVLA when it comes to, I don't know, the overall shape. It just looks much bigger than the DVLA, way bigger to handle and carry around. I would say the Harman Kardon has a bigger overall box. It definitely, yeah, is way taller, way wider, so it should have a bit more volume than the DVLA. But again, on higher volumes, looking at their size, the DVLA definitely is really impressive, as it pulls off quite a bit more than the Harman Kardon. But then keeping in mind the price and of course the battery of the Harman Kardon, it becomes quite obvious that the Harman Kardon can produce the same amount of kick as the Phantom, especially going to higher volumes. So now this is it. I also don't want to make the video too long, want to keep it quite compact in air quotes, it's probably way too long already. But yeah, overall, the question in the end is the Phantom worth it? And for me, I would say yes, but it really depends on what you are looking for. If you're looking for the best and biggest sound at that price, 1,300 euros, you can definitely get something else, but it will of course be way bigger than the Phantom. I personally think the price is justified because the Phantom is really unique. There's no other speaker at this price that is this small and packs so much punch. And I think this is just worth the money. If you're looking for a small speaker that is super powerful, the Phantom is the one to go. No other speaker can keep up with this despite being this small, at least on my experience. They all sound nicer, they sometimes have nicer treble and mid-range, and of course they are way less expensive, but they just won't keep up when it comes to the overall power. And I even think that the Phantom plays a little bit above its size class. It will definitely show some other speakers, even at a bigger size, how bass is done properly. But of course, if you're just looking for the biggest and, loudest speaker at this price, you can get some floor standards. But with the Phantom, you are really not only paying for the sound, but for that sound in this tiny package. And this is what I think makes it worth it for some people who are looking for exactly this. Again, summarizing the sound, I would say the low end definitely is the highlight of the speaker. Despite its small size, it's really impressive, a lot of control, sounds bigger than it is, as stupid as the sounds, it really does. Mid-range and treble has always been the issue of DVLA. Even with the bigger one, I think it doesn't sound right, especially for the much higher price of the bigger one. I think treble and mid-range should be better, but with this, I think they managed a nice overall sound package. What I also wanted to mention is, of course, again, the nice housing, which you are also paying for. It's really stable, very compact, handmade in France. And I think even bigger speakers won't have such a nice housing with that push-pull driver concept or driver layout, which also makes it unique. And again, the round shape gives you a really nice dispersion. So this might also be nice if you have a second one and you have a stereo pair, you will get a really nice open and probably also pretty decent sound stage. I'm not sure, I haven't tested it, but of course the shape definitely is a plus for the speaker, as it's always optimal to have a round shape instead of sharp corners or anything like that. Additionally, I also want to address that they fixed some of the, how to say this, weaknesses or user interface weaknesses of the bigger Phantom. I think it looks a bit more smooth, a bit more finished than the older or bigger one, and also doesn't have the Bluetooth issues anymore, so there's no crackling when it connects to Bluetooth anymore. It has welcome tones, it has buttons, it has a working on and off button, and there's no super loud hissing anymore. They also implemented loudness, which the bigger one didn't have, which was a huge con for me, as the bigger one had to be cranked to really high volumes in order to shine, while with this one you can listen at really low volumes and still get the full powerful sound with deep bass. So now I have to stop talking, the video gets way too long. If you enjoyed it and you want to see more, maybe comparison against the big gold Phantom, which I also have here, make sure to leave a like or subscribe to the channel to don't miss out on any new uploads in the future. Until then, have a great time and see you on the next one.